Islam, peace. What's going on? It's your brother, Denimel. And just want to talk about I've seen many different dialogues in regards to the condition or the state of hip hop. And I want to give my draw on that situation. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I'm tired of the okie doke, and I'm really tired of the people, the masses, not understanding the reason or the rationale behind the music's industry and why they use the term hip hop. You understand what I'm saying? First of all, we want to differentiate between what hip hop is and what the music industry's machination called rap is. You understand what I mean? What's so very important about this is that they seem to want to ball hip hop up, you know, ball hip hop up in this particular package. And this package is represented by a commercialized type of industry. You understand what I'm saying? And what I call it is, I call it the sindustry. The reason I call it that is because I know and understand that the contracts, you know what I'm saying, are satanic contracts, you know what I'm saying, are blood contracts and so on and so forth. Once an artist signs a contract into that sindustry, it's a wrap. The sindustry owns them. You see what I mean? And then on top of it, when you really think about the situation and you think about what hip hop is, right? And you think about the science of the originality of hip hop, the science of you know, being an artist, for instance, like in the music industry, they call the entertainers artists. Well, you truly can't live out your art form when somebody is controlling your thought processes or telling you what to do and telling you what to, you know, what to speak about or what to reference and so on and so forth. So when you look at the music industry's ideology of what they're calling hip hop, which is nothing more than a piece called rap, right? What they've done with the rap is they've packaged it up and put the name hip hop on it. But we don't understand the differentiation is this. Hip hop is not only a culture, but hip hop is a mental state. It's a condition of thinking. You understand what I'm saying? In order for hip hop to even exist, it had to be a particular types of minds that developed this expression, this cultural expression, you know what I'm saying, called hip-hop, that was built off of everything prior to the coming of what we would call hip-hop, to the coming of that thought and that dynamic self-expression that was wrapped around poverty and so on and so forth, created out of poverty to give us a methodology of expression to deal with our pain and so on and so forth, and to create a basis of unity, love, peace and so on and so forth. We could utilize this cultural paradigm, you know what I'm saying, to better ourselves. You know what I'm saying? Hip hop in its inception was a renaissance because it contained more than just what the industry is telling you today. See, rap, what they're calling it, I don't even call it, it's not even a part of the cultural paradigm. See, I call hip hop the culture. And what they're doing in the music industry, they're creating their own counterculture. You know what I'm saying? And they're utilizing these artists, or quote unquote so-called artists, that they pick and choose from, that they give the words to, you know, that they give them the words to speak and so on and so forth. And their influence reigns over our children through subliminal videos and music and so on and so forth. See what I'm saying? So we have to understand that we have to differentiate. We cannot allow, you know what I'm saying, the system to name and to tell us what our cultural paradigm is when it comes down to this art form, to this cultural, you know what I'm saying, magnificent, omnipotent art form that has spread across the planet. You know what I mean? You understand? The culture of hip-hop, it's a savior. It's a savior. It saves the world. The culture of hip-hop, it binds nations, all demographics together beyond language. You understand what I'm saying? Because it's the expression. You know what I mean? I don't have to talk to express myself. I can express myself in other ways. And that's the beautiful thing about hip hop, the culture. You understand what I'm saying? The culture is a holistic culture. You haven't seen hip hop in its inception because you know what? You can't see hip hop. Hip hop is something that you live. It's something that you live. And in its inception, there were components, you know what I'm saying? Or pieces that made up the holistic hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Like every real live person or individual who lives the culture will let you know and understand that we call it b-boying. We call it b-boying. A real b-boy had the skills to set in all the areas of the culture. Me personally, As a b-boy, I was a break dancer. I could pop. I could break dance. Break dancing was my thing because I was a martial artist. So mixing martial arts and the break dancing together, that was my thing. I was a beast. You understand what I'm saying? I could do graffiti. I couldn't bomb. For those who don't understand the language, bombing is putting up big pieces. You understand? Colorful pieces. You know what I'm saying? And they have different types of names for the bombing. Different types of styles. Wild style. You know what I'm saying? Block style. Barrel West style. They had all these different names. I couldn't wild style. I couldn't bomb. But I could tag. You understand what I'm saying? And I wasn't really nice on the wheels, but I could catch a beat. You understand what I'm saying? And I could MC. See, the difference is that we don't call what they call rapping. They call it rapping. We called it MCing because MCing was an art form. In order to be an MC, you had to have lyrical prowess in order to be an MC. I say it all the time. Rappers can rap, but rappers can't MC. But MCs can rap and MCs can MC. It's a big difference for me coming from the culture. Some people may say, well, that's just, you know, that just sounds like just, you know, rapping is rapping, MCing same thing. No, it's not. The ability to control a crowd is a science. You understand what I'm saying? And what we see today when I'm looking at these artists on stage, these so-called rappers, these so-called entertainers who are tools, who are being utilized, you know what I'm saying, by a system to further engage our children into some demonic and some nonsense, I see what they're doing. You understand what I'm saying? And our children fall victim because of the music itself, because of the subliminal messages, because of the spells that they work. You see what I'm saying? So again, the state of hip-hop isn't a good place. I will not allow a system to lie and say, oh, hip-hop is falling apart. Hip-hop has never fell apart. It's a culture. It's a mindset. You understand what I'm saying? As long as people like me are alive, you can never kill the paradigm of hip-hop, the cultural paradigm. It can never be destroyed, and it can never be packaged up. You can't package up the culture. Y'all tried to do it. Y'all did it with, y'all do it with these rappers. You know what I'm saying? And y'all call that hip-hop. But that's not what hip-hop is. That is your machination, and you can have that industry. You can have it because really we don't want that because we know and understand with the culture of hip hop that we are creators and we've always been creators and we continue to create and we don't have to use the mainstream. We can use the underground. We have it to the point now where we have all of these different methods of social media, all of these different tools. We can create our own Hollywood. We can create our own industries, so why not do it when we know and understand what this culture really is? Because the industry doesn't, and the industry will give you the facade of what it is. See, they did it. They did it a couple of times. They wanted to sit down and try to destroy hip-hop and put another taint on it. They did it in 1986 when they brought N.W.A. out and when they created their machination called gangster rap. Gangster rap belongs to this industry. That is their machination. Now, people will say, well, nah, gangster rap has always been around. Nah, it hasn't always been around. I was there from the inception. It hasn't always been around. Even though we have had people on the East Coast at the inception that we had called gangsters. For instance, Just Ice. We called Just Ice the gangster. You understand what I'm saying? But the stuff he kicked, it wasn't like what N.W.A. kicked. You know what I'm saying? The dope, it wasn't like that. The gang, it was an East Coast thing. You understand what I'm saying? And it was totally culturally represented and culturally understood. You know what I'm saying? Hustling and gangsters. You know what I mean? It was understood, but it wasn't from that paradigm. There was no cussing in the songs. You know what I'm saying? There was no misogynistic lyrics. That came at a later date and time after 86. You understand what I'm saying? And it came in a time to combat what was happening on this side, the awakening that was going on over here with Eric B and Rakim, Public Enemy, BDP, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of other X-Clan, PRT, a lot of other artists. You see what I'm saying? So what they did was they put together this machination called rap, gangster rap, and they created it. You understand? And they created it with N.W.A., who was the first covert, you know what I'm saying, operation. You know what I mean? COINTELPRO operation. It is what it is. And by the time before Eazy-E got knocked off, he knew what it was and he began to warn you. You know what I'm saying? And I'm sipping some ginger tea right now, so bear with me. So, we're going to decode hip-hop. We're going to make you understand that hip-hop is a holistic culture. And it can't be bagged up and packaged up. It can only be lived and lived out and excelled in and passed on from mouth to ear. There's a science behind hip-hop, man. And we will not I will not allow the industry, the sindustry, to tell me what it is and what it's not. You know what I'm saying? You can fall for the okie doke, and you can, you know, youngsters, you can think you know what hip hop is, but you have no clue what hip hop really is. You understand what I mean? You have no clue what it is. And the beautiful thing is that there are people like me who know exactly what it is because I'm a part of it. I'm a part of the culture. The first generation of hip hop is where I come from. You understand what I'm saying? I'm a B-boy to death do us part. It just is what it is. So if you want to know about what this culture really is, you should really holler at me and talk to me, because I can give you a definite draw on what this culture is and definitely what it's not. Because it's not what you see on the MTV Awards. It is not what you see on the Video Music Awards. It is not what you see on Television. It's not what you see. You understand what I'm saying? Hip hop is revolutionary, and the revolution can never be televised. You can never catch that drastic change across cameras. You understand what I'm saying? So with that being stated, I want you to know and understand that hip hop is a culture, a holistic culture that is lived out. You know what I'm saying? We utilize it. It's a part of our daily makeup. You understand what I'm saying? The language, the garbs, the dress code, the psychological and spiritual components of the culture itself. The emceeing, the breakdancing, the popping. You understand? The language, the words we use. You know what I'm saying? We formulated the beats, the sounds, the production. We formulated a whole cultural paradigm, the art on the walls. You know what I'm saying? We call graffiti. The ancients called it hieroglyphics, so we got modern day hieroglyphics. So it's a whole culture over here, man. Y'all caught up on this music industry stuff and this gangster rap, and now they got this transhumanism, transgenderism rap music, you know what I'm saying? Druggy rap music, and y'all confused. Your children are confused with their genders. They don't know if they're boys or girls, you know what I'm saying? They don't know. And that's the problem with the industry. See, they're using rap the way that the culture used it to wake you up. But what they're doing is they're putting you to sleep with this. You understand? They're subliminally implanting devilish information in you, and you're acting out on it. So it's time for the culture to resurrect itself in its full bloom, because it's never left. It's never left. And when the culture resurrects itself to its full bloom, it will destroy this industry. It will beat it to death. You understand what I'm saying? Because you know what? We can move without it. When hip hop started, there was no music industry for us. It was a cultural thing. You know what I'm saying? It was our expression. And then somebody put money into play and turned it into something else. They started extracting aspects of it and trying to remove certain things and trying to control the emceeing aspect. It went from the DJ to the MC. Originally, it was the DJ who was the main attraction. Then they flipped it to the MC. You see what I'm saying? So now what we're looking at today is, when I look at all of these mumble rappers and I look at all of these quote unquote industry rappers who've made some money in the industry, you know what I'm saying? Talk about how we should let this new generation of rappers shine and let them do what they do and let them do their thing. But what they're doing is they're destroying our communities. You know what I'm saying? They're allowed, they're teaching certain things to our children. You know what I mean? And for you cats who, you know, who've made your money, and now y'all got record labels and all of these things y'all got going on, y'all want to allow this devilishment to occur and to continue to occur because you may benefit from it. Well, I'm here to let you know. You know what I'm saying? Those artists suck. You know what I'm saying? I don't give them any play or any leeway. I'm not gonna let them do their thing. You know what I'm saying? Because their thing is destruction. I don't respect Lil Yachty. I don't respect Lil Uzi Vert. I don't respect Young Thug. I don't respect none of those dudes, man. I don't respect Xanax. I don't respect Webby. Not Webby. The Triple Red or whatever their names are. You know what I'm saying? I don't respect them. There's one cat that I examined a little bit, and he alright. NBA Youngboy. He's alright. You know what I'm saying? He's okay because he's expressing something. He's going through something, and he's letting the world know. He's emceeing right now. He's talking to you. You understand what I'm saying? So, but a lot of these other cats, these youngsters, they're tools. And they're tools to lead our children astray, specifically because they're influential. And our children watch them on the television, and they have influence on our seeds, man. You understand what I'm saying? And wherever they go, your seeds may go. And if they go to hell psychologically and emotionally, your seeds will go too. So, hip-hop, is not the industry. Hip hop is separate from the industry. The industry, that's their own thing, and they want to use the term hip hop, but we're taking that back. It doesn't belong to you. Just call it what it is, what y'all got over there, a music industry. The music's industry, and you use rappers and entertainers. You know, just call it what it is, because over here, we live hip hop. It's a whole culture. And I don't think that anybody want to come in and try to distinguish or take away from the cultural paradigm, because, you know, people talk about, in the industry, they talk about Liar Cohen. They call him the man and all, yeah, whatever. Him and Russell Simmons. You know what I'm saying? But you know what? Liar Cohen doesn't impress me. He's a culture vulture, like many of them are. You know what I'm saying? I don't give him respect. He doesn't hold nothing for me or the culture. You understand what I'm saying? Nothing for us or the culture. We can get rid of him just from a thought. He doesn't exist in our world. Because we don't want his handouts. Because in order to get his handouts, there's some things that we got to do to get Liar Cohen's handouts. We don't want his handouts. We can create our own method. We can create our own lane. We can do it. Just understand that you can create your own lane without the validation of this industry. You see what I mean? So hip-hop is originality. Hip-hop is entrepreneurial. Hip-hop is mind. You understand what I'm saying? You can't baggage or package it up. Hip-hop is mental. It's a mind thing. It's a conditioning. And from that condition, there are results from the hip-hop condition, from the mind state. There are results that came out of that. And the results are a renaissance of expression. You understand what I'm saying? And the disseminating of pertinent information to change the condition of our people. That's what the culture of hip-hop is all about. It's about revolution. It's about drastic change, starting with the individual first and the community as well. You see what I mean? So with that being stated, I just wanted to let you know, you know what I'm saying, that there's nothing wrong with the state of hip-hop. What's wrong is those who are trying to define what hip-hop is and trying to steal the culture. Not even trying to steal the culture, but trying to use the name of the culture to push their own agenda, because they can only push it through our genius. See what I'm saying? This is the same nation that takes our plight and makes millions off of our plights of trauma. Now they're taking our expression and want to bag that up and make millions off of that as well. You see what I'm saying? But we gotta begin to fight back. Hip hop belongs to us. It doesn't belong to anybody else. Everybody else are visitors. They're guests. We allow them in. You understand what I'm saying? And when they come in, they take advantage of the situation. You see what I mean? So we got to start kicking people out and not allowing them in. Because what they do is they get in here and then they go to the other side into the industry and then talk about the culture. Or don't give the culture what it deserves, the gratitude and the grace that it deserves. You know what I'm saying? Hip-hop is a pristine art form in its pristine purity. It is divine. Because of what it came through and what it came from. It's divine. You understand what I'm saying? So with that being stated, I'm going to say peace.